Across this great nation, there is a culture of people who carry on a heritage. They have an intangible quality that can't be described, but it comes from deep within their hearts. They share an appreciation for the greatest things that come from Mother Earth. They watch over, understand, and care for the vast wilds of this great country. Fishing, hunting, and trapping are the foundations that Canada was built on. For over two centuries, we have taken to the woods and water to pursue wild game. Today, it's about conservation, preservation, and wildlife management. Whether you are a man or woman, fish or hunt, you should support sound wildlife management and proudly say, I am an angler and hunter. The Ontario Federation of Anglers and Hunters proudly presents Angler and Hunter Television. Brought to you by Canadian Tire, a proud partner of Angler and Hunter Television, Mercury Marine and Lund Boats, Yamaha ATVs, Winchester Ammunition, Browning Firearms, Suffolk Fishing Line, Rapala, Camillus Knives, Excalibur Crossbows, and Yukon Gear.
Fish right here.
Oh, it's a fish. That's a fish. Snag.
That's a fish, Mike.
It is.
It's a fish. Yeah. We're deep enough, dude.
Oh,
that's
yeah,
a big
man.
Fish.
It's pulling.
That's a big fish.
I thought it was snag.
No way, man. Not out here.
There he is. Oh, he's a nice one.
Is he a good one? Oh, yeah, Mike.
Whoa.
Nice fish, buddy. Okay. He is.
Oh, don't let him swim away.
In the bag, buddy.
I did that for TV.
Every season, I try to put together an action-packed, over-the-top musky episode.
That's a nice-looking musky right there, eh?
Beautiful fish.
Nice flat head on him.
Now, we have had some luck and managed to showcase some fish through both trolling and casting.
That's a 40-inch fish right on the nose.
Man, that's a bang-on 40. Yeah. I'll take those all day out here.
But I'm still searching for the ultimate day on the water to show just how incredible musky fishing can be.
Awesome, man.
There you go.
Take that all day long.
Let's get at it and do it again.
Yeah.
Last season, while filming with Rob Cadeau on Lake St. Clair, he mentioned a spot near Sault Ste. Marie, Ontario, where he had some of his best days casting for muskie on a river system that feeds into Lake Superior of all places. So on this episode, we're headed to Sault Ste. Marie to hook up with the muskie guru and try to get some toothy monsters on camera for you.
There's one. Oh, yeah.
Musky. No, pike.
Esox Lucius.
It's a grassy pike.
Hey, that's a nice
one. It's a nice pike, though.
Yeah, take care of that thing. Want a hand?
No, I think I'm all right, Mike.
Okay.
A little pike. Should be able to.
He's fat.
Piker.
He's not real long, but he's fat.
Okay.
That's a nice pike.
Yeah, hooked on the outside of the head.
He struck it. Look at the belly on that thing.
Yeah, nice pike. Not quite what we're after, but it's okay.
It's fun.
There he goes.
Wow, he's an ornery pike.
Yes, he is. Most of them are.
Right ornery. Good for you.
Mm-hmm.
We used to call you the musky guru, now I'm going to start calling you the pike guru.
Not the love guru?
Well, I haven't witnessed that.
Yeah.
We're on the Goulet River, or as some people say, Goulet.
Yes, sir.
We got here last night, and we came out for 2 or 3 hours. And it was windy, caught a couple pike.
Yeah, not a bad fish. Let's get them back.
Had a couple nice fish on.
Yeah, we did. We had a couple nice ones on.
Got him!
Musky, big musky.
He's just ready.
Good man. Let me get the net. On the bucktail, baby.
Oh,
just
barely,
take your time, Mike.
Barely
take your time,
man.
Oh, he's come off!
I told you he was barely hooked. I was feathering him. That was a big one.
That was a good fish, Mike.
Yeah, I had one come right to the boat and hit beside the boat, and then we had a couple of bigger fish roll on our baits out at the end of long cast, so. Oh, he missed it. Oh, it's got swirled on right there. See that?
You got him?
Yep.
Well, Musky. That's a bigger fish.
He's off.
Oh, is he?
He's off.
It's off to a good start.
But as you can see, last night it was 50 kilometer an hour winds.
Yeah.
And it was hot yesterday, but it cooled down last night. And there's not a cloud in the sky. We got high pressure, a little cooler.
Water temperatures have gone down 5 degrees since last night.
That's not good for muskies, is it?
No, not good for any of them, really. But they're here.
I got faith in you.
They're here and they're going to eat, so.
The Gooley River drains into Lake Superior, just north of Sault Ste. Marie. And one thing Lake Superior isn't known for is its musky fishing. Up until you came here a couple years ago and showed everybody. Hey?
Yeah, well, I've been guiding out here on this river for about 20 years now. So.
But, you know, famous musky waters in Ontario are like Eagle Lake, Lake of the Woods, Lac Seul.
Yeah.
No one thinks of Lake Superior and some of the tributaries off it. And from the pictures you showed me, there's some big ones living in here.
Yeah, there is. And we also, well, you saw some of the pike that we catch, but we catch some really big pike as well. And because of that, we get quite a few tiger muskies as well.
Well, it's a nice wide river. It's shallow. I mean, we're looking at an average depth of 5-6 feet.
Yep.
So they don't have many places to hide except for wood. So you just basically go down the shoreline and cast wood, right?
Yep, wood, a little bit of weed cover. You know, any kind of current break that you can find. There's even, you know, steep drop-offs here. Now, you know, it's not all that big. You're going from,
I saw maybe 14 feet of water last night.
Yeah, but I mean, there's the, what I mean by steep drop off, you might go from 2 feet to 4 feet, but it'll be a wall, you know?
Right. Oh my God, I'm near a big brush pile there.
They'll lay right near those, and one of the big secrets is getting your lure right up to the shore.
You shouldn't have said that.
Yeah.
Now everybody's gonna cast to the shore and catch them.
Yeah, that was my
fault. You're gonna
get
my fish.
I know.
This portion of Angler and Hunter Television brought to you by Yamaha ATVs.
Casting for muskie is trying and repetitive. In fact, it requires you to focus more than any other style of fishing, simply because muskie will often follow right to the edge of the boat. And if you aren't ready, well, you'll be the guy talking about the one you almost caught.
Oh, yeah.
Big muskie, Mike. Keep going on him. That's a big fish.
Yeah, that was a real thick one.
That's a big fish, dude. Come up a little bit. See if he's there.
Oh, man.
Dude.
That was a thick fish.
That was a big fish.
He was like, good.
Yeah, good and wide and long.
Maybe I did get hit back there.
Cast after cast, we scoured the banks of the river, throwing blue fox bucktails, Rapala subwalks, and countless other swim baits and topwater baits.
And if you turn 1 out of 10 into a biter, that's a good day.
1 out of 10?
Well, yeah, I mean, you're
going to see one.
You're hoping to see one. We already saw one back there.
The strategy for connecting with muskie in the river is to focus on bends and current breaks that had weed beds or submerged timber that the fish could use for cover.
Oh yeah.
There's one. Oh yeah.
Musky. Good fish. Big musky. Big musky, Mike. Get that net ready. Ah, that's a good fish. Nice fish.
Oh, come on, Patton! God!
Oh, I'm sorry.
I can't believe it. Oh no. Okay. Let's do a. Hang on a second here.
No.
We have been casting for one full day.
Oh.
We could have easily put 8 or 9 nice muskies in the boat.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
And we got none to show for it.
Nothing.
You could cast and hook and musky fish, but they're the only fish that I've ever encountered. That, like,
man, they just get off. Who knows?
How do they come unbuttoned like that? Yeah. You know, it happens a lot, but man, it's been a tough slog.
10,000 casts. Is that what this is going to take?
There you go. Is he still there? Now you're down deeper.
Oh, he has got me buried in something, man.
He's underneath the
Yeah,
the
he's log under here. A tree.
He's under this log.
Weird.
There he is.
There he is,
right there, yeah.
But when I let my line go, I could feel him swimming. What a nightmare.
Hold on.
There's the tree there.
Yeah, just hold on.
No, use your arm.
I'm not going to be able to reach out with my arm, Mike.
It's off.
He's gone. Yeah.
That's the way it happens to you right there. Look at my bait.
Where she goes.
Just when I thought all was lost and that the fish gods rode to get us, I finally spotted a fish, and I knew it was one I could put in the boat.
There is
smallmouth!
Smallmouth,
big smallmouth!
Big smallies, look at the size of them!
Look at them all. Oh, you got, you missed them!
Giant smallmouth bass were everywhere, cruising the banks, tucked under log jams, and a well-placed shadow wrap was the ticket for getting those big brutes to bite.
There he is, got him. Got him, good bass, Mike. Oh, stay down. Stay Holy down, big girl. Stay down. This is a beautiful smallie.
That's a giant.
She crushed it. Look at that thing sideways in her mouth.
Oh, I gave you the hex wrap.
Yes, sir. I pumped it like three times and she crushed it. You ready?
No.
Here she comes.
Oh, I'm not ready yet. I'm not ready. I'm not ready yet.
There we go.
Good nice thing we got this musky net for these giant bass.
Holy.
Was it on the wood?
Yeah, she was right on that log that we were just talking about.
Watch your fingers.
Just a beautiful big smallmouth. Let me get her unbuttoned here. All right, Mike. That's a beautiful fish. Look at that bait.
Ate it.
Yeah.
Where is it? Right on the wood?
Right on that log.
Wow.
What a gorgeous smallmouth. Lake Superior bronzeback.
Right there. You're not supposed to tell people where we are. As if you can't see out there. Not many lakes that big. Nice fish, brother.
There she goes. That's the way. Beauty fish.
I didn't even get a chance to get my rod.
You got to be quick around here, buddy.
We've been seeing those giant smallies coming off the wood.
Hey, what
is there any more in there?
Oh, there's a bunch more, I'm sure of it.
Well, if I get one on now, I'm done. Here comes one.
There's one. Oh, that was a big one.
You pulled off him.
It was in her mouth and out again, dude. That was a big one.
I am putting the talon down.
You got one? Giant bass.
I was dead sticking it. Oh man, it's way down there deep.
Oh, and that's a big bass.
I haven't even, this fish hasn't come to the surface yet.
She's too fat to jump.
Wow.
Look at this.
That's the coolest thing about that shadow wrap is I threw it out there and I let it sink almost like a jig. And when it hit bottom,
man, look at her pull. Look at her pull. That's an incredible fish, Mike.
It almost went into the talon. Here she comes.
Okay.
Oh, don't get off. The hook's come out of her mouth. It's up on alongside her head here.
Oh, Mike.
There you go.
Oh, she's in
the flap and hang. I can grab her right here like this.
I'll get that hook up there now, Mike.
These things are tanks. And it's not a football-shaped bass. Like, that is a straight belly. You know how to tell a big smallie, dude? Is their tail. The squareness right here.
That's a big fish, Mike.
And look at this fish realistically.
You need pliers?
No. These are these shadow wraps have real fine hooks
in. Yeah. See the marks all over it?
Yeah.
From spawning?
Yeah, well, we saw these fish stacked up under that tree. And now I'm going to measure that fish, but
yeah.
See right here, there's a board. Pull, right, yeah. pull that all board right. out of there.
Nice measuring stick. All right.
Now, see how thick that tail is? This is a big smallie, but it isn't round, eh?
Oh, not right there.
Just under 20 inches.
Yeah.
And a 20-inch fish is usually around 4 and change.
Yeah.
But that fish got a lot of potential to grow.
For sure.
Wicked.
What a beast.
There's muskies in this river that'll eat that. I mean, that's kind of why I hooked up with you, is because the pictures you show me, the muskies you catch at the mouth of this river are mind-blowing.
Yeah, it can be really good.
But you can see why those bass are hiding tight to the wood and stuff, because there's big esox in here.
Yeah.
But we did learn something. Like, I was throwing a crankbait, messing around, trying to catch those fish that were following, and if it floated up, they'd lose interest in it. But if
right
it
away,
sank down or suspended, they'd come back over and eat it. So that's two in a row.
Yeah, good job.
let's catch a couple more of them.
Okay.
This portion of Angler and Hunter Television brought to you by Winchester Ammunition.
Come and get it. Who knew that Lake Superior had some of the best smallmouth fishing in Canada?
There we go.
There's a fish.
Oh, it's a big one.
Big one, too.
That's a big fish. Yeah, there you go. Leave some line.
Yep, that's a big fish again, Mike.
I gotta get you the net.
I can't believe we have to get the net.
Oh, my goodness, Mike. She's not hooked very well either, Mike.
She's being good right now.
Get her.
Oh, she tried to fly out of the net. Wow,
oh, and she's off. See, Mike, she was
right on
this
wood there.
There's
one sitting right there. Look at that one
suspended. Oh, my God.
Beside it. Nice work.
Right, let me grab this one. Oh, look at the size of this bass, dude.
Another bruiser.
We'll get that out of the net shortly. Look at that for a bass. Another big one. You want to measure that one, too?
Probably the same. That's a cloner.
Yeah. It's got marks on it, too, from spawning. All right, let's just put this on the board.
You broke 20.
Hey, 20 and a half inches.
Wow, man, these are giants. That's insane.
20 and a half inch smallie on wood. Right on. I tell you, those X-wraps are crazy. Let's get this one back in the water, Mike. Oh, look at the size of that bass.
Jeez, man. These fish are like all over, nearly 2 feet long.
I know.
Like, if you take 2 feet at home and look at it, it's giant. Like, these are giants.
Yes, they are, sir. We catch a lot of these fish on big musky baits.
Musky guru, meet bass guru. Even Rob couldn't resist catching bass fever, and in no time, we both had all but forgotten those musky that gave us such a hard time.
Got one.
Good fish.
Not bad.
Nice fish.
Oh, there's three big
ones
with them.
Yeah, there's three big ones with them.
Throw it in there. I'm going to put the towel down.
Oh, he's going for it, Mike. He's going for it.
Twitch it. Have you noticed these fish don't jump a lot?
No, they're too fat to jump.
They want to go into the wood.
You know, I wonder if it's also because of the colder water.
Maybe. Okay, we got the talon down here, so we can work this spot. Now that's like a nice little,
God.
Look at the hooks in this fish.
And that's the smallest of the three.
Yeah.
We just saw here.
The difference in hooks between the X-wrap and the shadow wraps.
Yeah.
The shadow wraps really are a finesse bait. Because you can work them. Whereas the X-wrap, it's an extreme bait where you gotta really get it to work.
There's one right there.
Nice one. Oh yeah.
Good fish, yeah. Decent fish. Yeah, that's a decent fish.
Need the net for him or?
No, I think I'll be all right, Mike.
He's got a belly on him.
Yeah, it's got a bigger belly. I'm just gonna try and limp it here. Oh yeah, she's got some gut to her. But again, you know, no jumping really, which is good. Come on over here. Come on over here, girl. There we go, got her. There we go.
We just scared two giants out of this log when I hit it.
There's another decent fish, Mike. On that X-wrap.
See the hooks now?
Yeah, they are a little bit bigger, right?
Compare those hooks here.
Than the ones that are on yours.
You got a real heavy hook on that bait.
Yeah, for sure.
You can see you should be throwing the shad wrap on the spin rod, and I should have that on the bait caster.
But another salt. Look at that. Look at its side. It just ate something huge.
Wow.
Look at how fat that is through there. Like its spine.
Oh,
you see
yeah.
the way the spine
it's
is?
It's deformed.
On? Wow.
That's kind of cool.
Let's put her back. There she goes. Beautiful fish.
That's a nice one.
The Fishing Edge is brought to you by Minn Kota and Humminbird.
To get the edge over the bass, I used a 7'2" medium heavy Rapala R-type rod with a 200 series Rapala shift baitcast reel, spooled with Suffix 832 braid and a 10 pound Suffix fluorocarbon leader tied to a Rapala shadow wrap. The Minn Kota Altera had us creeping up on these unsuspecting smallies, and the Talon allowed us to hold in position so we could work around the heavy cover. And a trusty Lucky Strike net made sure these bruisers came in the boat. The weather for this fishing trip had high pressure with clear skies and light winds, which had the musky short striking and the bass holding tight to cover. Got one.
You got oh, bruiser!
Oh, yeah.
A bruiser, Mike. Big bass, big bass. Let me get the net.
Whoa! There's five with them. Look at them all.
Is there?
Oh my gosh! This place is the bass mecca.
Look at the size of that bass. Oh, there is a pile of them. Oh, dude, that is an absolute pig of a fish, Mike. And they're all still with them.
Okay.
Here
yeah.
we go, buddy. All right, dude.
Man.
Let's get that fish out of the net for you.
Split tail.
Look at that.
Hold him over there. Show everybody that thing.
That's a conger, too.
Look at that bass. Another giant bass. Real fat, beautiful fish. Wow.
Nice one, man.
That's 19 plus inches, too. Beautiful. Oh, man, it's fat. Super fat fish.
I think we're gonna catch a couple more off that stick. Holy mackerel. This trip was a real eye-opener for me, and I will without a doubt be coming back to Lake Superior.
Oh man, there's some huge bass here.
I have a feeling that we merely scraped the surface of its untapped potential.
Closed captioning of Angler and Hunter Television is brought to you in part by Ontario Out of Doors Magazine. Angler and Hunter Television has been brought to you by Canadian Tire, Mercury Marine and Lund Boats, Yamaha ATVs, Winchester Ammunition, Browning Firearms, Suffix Fishing Line, Rapala, Camillus Knives, Excalibur Crossbows, and Yukon Gear. For more information on the products used in this episode of Angler and Hunter Television, visit ahtv.com. Be sure to like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter. Remember, conserve and protect our great outdoors.